but to impress upon you, I've been where you guys want to go and where your parents would like to see you go, and that's play the college game. The one thing I'll tell you right now for parents and for players, because I'm a living example of this, there is a home for everybody. There is a home for everybody if you want to play college basketball. I played Division III, which is a small college ball. I played for a guy by the name of Tom Thibodeau. Who knows that name? Who's Tom Thibodeau? Coach of the Bulls. No, that was last job.
Minnesota
Timberwolves. He's the head coach.
Close.
So Thibodeau was my coach at Hamilton College, Division III school in Massachusetts. I didn't get recruited to play. I walked on. I forced myself on him. I was persistent that I wanted to be part of the team. So if I can make a team with limited ability, athletically, and limited skill, anybody in this gym. But the difference is this. If you want to play college basketball, that's not good enough. You got to want it badly. You got to really want it badly. That's the difference between wanting something and wanting something badly. If you want it badly, you'll make the sacrifices. You'll dedicate yourself. When you get to that fork in the road of which direction to go in, you'll always take the path of doing what it takes to get there. So I want you to feel very optimistic. If you really want to play college ball, and parents who want your kids to play and they want to play, you got to have the right grades, you got to have the right ability, and then you have to have the right character. I love to tell you this phrase. Coaches look for three things. They look for character, academics, and talent. And I like to use the acronym CAT, C-A-T. You got to maximize your CAT. You can't just work on your game because talent's not enough. You've got to work on your character. You've got to work on the person that you are. You've got to work on your brains. See, coaches are looking for kids with high character because when the talent is the same, coach is going to pick someone who they believe as a person with higher character, somebody they can really trust, somebody who's really respectful, somebody who's really loyal. These are the things coaches look for, guys that are real passionate about the game, guys that know how to sacrifice, guys that are self-disciplined. These are the characteristics coaches look for. They can't see it with the eye. See, coaches can see talent with their eye. Heart, passion, discipline, kindness, respectfulness. They have to dig that. They have to go dig that research. They have to talk to your teachers, which they do. They have to talk to your coaches. They have to talk to all the people around you. So if you have character that's high, meaning that you really live your life in a good way, everybody's going to make mistakes and nobody's going to be perfect. But when nobody's looking, we can trust what you say. We can trust what you do. We can trust how you treat people. Oh, let me tell you something. That goes a long way. A long way. Self-discipline. I mean, we don't have to wake him up to go to class. He's going to go on his own. Somebody who's going to put the time into the schoolwork. Somebody who's going to take school seriously. We don't have to follow you to class to make sure you go. We don't have to make sure you go to your tutor. Coaches want guys that are given A-plus effort in the classroom. You don't have to get A-pluses, but you got to give an A-plus effort in the classroom. That's what coaches want. Coaches want guys that are low maintenance, but highly productive. Because what are coaches trying to do? What are coaches trying to do? What? What are coaches trying to do? I can't hear. Get you better, that's one thing. What's their ultimate goal though?
Win.
And part under winning is get you better, make you a better person than you already came in as, make you a better student, emphasize your academics and follow up with you, and make you a better player. But their job is to win, and those are subcategories. So I can guarantee you right now, if you try to maximize your CAT, your character, work on your character. Everybody wants to work on their jump shot, and that's cool. You should work on your skills all day long. You shouldn't be on your phone all the time. Phone's not gonna get you a scholarship. Your phone's not gonna get you a spot on a team. And you gotta know this. Division I, 13 scholarships. Division II, I think it's 15. Division III, there is no scholarships, but there is financial aid. For those who are academically strong and those that are academically in need. So you have to really need the money, like really need it, or you have to have such great grades, they'll give you money for your grades. So you don't have to pay for school. You may have to pay for something, may not have to pay for anything. And I know as a parent, I don't want to pay for anything. I know how expensive school is. I have two daughters. Nobody's getting scholarships in my house, academic or athletic. So I know how hard it is to work for the money, to make the money, to pay for you guys to go to school. And your parents are here now, relatives, parents, because they care about you. So I want them to hear the same thing I'm saying. Develop their character, develop their academics, develop their talent. Help them develop those three things. And when it comes to academics, prepare for your ACT or your SAT. You get a low grade to start on that test is really hard. I know that. It's not gonna define how successful you're gonna be, but colleges look at that number on your ACT or SAT, and they match you up to thousands of other kids. So this is the message I'm trying to tell you. You've got to do something to separate yourself. You've got to do something to separate yourself. And I guarantee you, if you max out your character, your academics, and your talent, you'll have a good chance, if you really want to play college basketball, you will. And then once you go to college and you're playing ball, now you open a whole new set of doors.